morning, children. Welcome back to social science class. See, children, in previous class, we all discussed history part in first lesson, Advent of the Europeans to India. Today, we are going to study civics part in first lesson, our defense force. Understand, children? Today, we are going to study civics part in first lesson, our defense force.
Armed forces.
Understand, children? This responsibility, it means this responsibility is what? To protect our country from the foreign attacks or foreign aggression. This responsibility given to the our defense forces or armored forces. Understand, children? Next, the role of our defense forces was prominent. Understand, children? See, now I am teaching introduction about the our defense forces. Understand? The role of our defense forces was prominent. Prominent means important to our country. Prominent means what? Important. Understand? See. And we have to find. India has as a efficient, powerful and aggressive.
Understand, children? See, after the independence, then we got the
examples. China attacked to India. India on October. On October 20th. 1962. Understand? Very, very important. After the independence, our defense forces faced several challenges or many challenges. Which are the problems are faced by our Indian forces is? Example is there. China attacked to India on October 20, 1962. When China our country, that time our defense forces give the protection to our country. Understand? Next example, Pakistan. Pakistan was India on 1947 to 1948. This is called Pak-Indo-War. Understand children? Pak-Indo-War happened in on 1947 to stop it. Indo-Pak War was started on 1947 and this war was ended in 1947. Why they are happening this battle is or war is to distribution of the princely states, example Jammu and Kashmir. Understand? The distribution of princely state Jammu and Kashmir. These purpose of attack to India on 1947. Understand? This war was ended in 1948. That time our defense forces is show or display the efficient power against the Pakistan and give the protection to our country. And next example, Kargil fight. Kargil fight or conflict. Conflict means galabe. Kargil galabe athava Kargil porata. This was happened on May 1999. Understand? Kargil conflict was happened on May 1999. This was ended July 23, 1999. Understand? This year is very, very memorable in our history. Why means July every year, July 23rd, we all celebrated Kargil Divas. Understand? See, Kargil fight or conflict on May 1999 started and ended July 23rd, 1999. That time also our Indian force give the protection to our country and so many soldiers were sacrificed their lives in that conflict or in that fight. Understand children? These are the more important or prominent examples for our defense forces display the efficiently powerful give the protection to our country. Understand children? This is very, very important. body, and which are the conflict or which are the fight disturbed to our Indian integrity? Which are the fight, war or conflict were disturbed the Indian integrity? That day our defense forces give the protection to our country. Understand? These are the introduction about the our defense forces. Understand children? This is very very important lesson in civics part. Understand? Okay. Next, we move on the topic. Border of India. How much? See border of our country. See 7,560.5 kilometers. Understand? Kilometers. India has its own sea border. Understand? India has its land border area is 11,200 kilometers, and sea border of India 7,560.5 kilometers. Understand children? Next, what are the responsibilities performed by our defense forces? Now we will discuss which are the responsibilities of our defense forces. Responsibilities of our defense forces. Very very important. Which are the responsibilities of our defense forces perform? First one is border areas. Very very important. First responsibility of our defense forces. First one is to protect the border area. Sea border area also and land border area also protected by our defense forces. Second one is safeguarding the integrity of the country. Safeguarding the integrity of the Smuggling. Smuggling. Activities. Smuggling. Activities. ID. National. National. Activities. International activities. Preventing means control. Preventing means what? Control. See, to protect the border areas. Border areas. Gadi Pradeshagalige Rakshane Niduvanta Ondu Jovabdariyanna Namma Rakshana Padegalu Nirvahisuttave. It means what? Gadi Pradeshagalige Rakshane Niduvanta Jovabdariyanna Namma Rakshana Padegalu Nirvahisuttave. Second one is safeguarding the integrity of the country. Deshada Aikyateyannu Kapaduvanta Jovabdariyanna Nirvahisuttave. And third one is preventing. Preventing means controlling. Niyantrana Madutte Yavudanna Anta Helidre Smuggling activities. Smuggling chatuvatikeyanna and also Desha Virodhi chatuvatikegalanna ee ondu our defense forces en madutte protection madutte athava control madutte. Understand children, which are the responsibilities are performed by our defense forces means first one is to protect the border areas. Very very important. Gadi Pradeshagalannu. Next, safeguarding the integrity. Integrity means aikyate. Deshada aikyateyanna kapaduttare. And preventing means control. Niyantranakke taruthe yavudanna andre smuggling activities and also anti national activities. These are the very very important responsibilities of our defense forces. Understand children? Next. The supreme power given to the our defense forces, the President of India. The supreme power is given to the our defense forces is vested to the President of India. Who had the supreme power of our defense forces means our President of India. Our President of India. Mr. President of India had the supreme power of our defense forces. The supreme power is given through the our defense forces is vested to the President of India. Very very important. Who is given to the supreme power to the our defense forces? This question for answer is President of India. Understand children? Next. Now we will discuss divisions of our defense forces. How many divisions we can find in our defense forces? Divisions of our defense forces. Very very important. They are three Three divisions. How many divisions? There are three divisions in our defense forces. Which are they? First one is army force. Second one is navy force. Navy force. Third one is air force. Third one is air force. Very important. Understand? Divisions of our defense forces. They are three divisions are there in our defense forces. First one is army forces. Second one is navy forces. And third one is air force. It means Sena Padai or Bhu Sena Padai. We say in Kannada army force. We say in Kannada navy force. Navuma Padai. Padai Dada, like that we have to say. Air force, Vayu Padai. Vayu Dada, Nauka Dada, Sena Dada. Understand? Army force means we say in Kannada Sena Padai or Sena Padai. Navy force we say in Kannada Nauka Padai. And air force we say in Kannada Vayu Padai. These are the three divisions of our defense forces. Understand? These three divisions show their strength. Shows their strengthiness and unity. In the celebration of Independence Day. Independence Day and Republic Day. Understand? These three divisions of force shows their strengthiness and unity in the celebration of Independence Day and also Republic Day. Understand, children? Now, we will discuss important training centers of our defense forces. What? Important training centers of our defense force. Important training centers of our defense forces. Understand? First one. See, one question is there. Name the important training centers of our defense forces. That time you have to write the answer. Understand? Which are the important training centers we can find in our country? First one is National Defense College. First one is National Defense College. This is the first training centers of our defense forces. Second one is military, military academy. Next one is Dehradun. Second one is Dehradun. Dehradun and National Defense Academy. And National Defense Academy. Understand? Next one is Kodak. Is in Pune. Is in Pune. See children, very very important training centers of our defense forces. First one is National Defense College. Second one is Defense Service Training Center. Next one is Indian Military Academy. Next one is Dehradun and National Defense Academy and Kodak. Is it today? These are all important training centers of our defense forces. Understand children? Next. Now we will discuss first division of our defense forces, that is Army Force. Army Force or Indian Army. Very very important first division of our defense forces. First one, which one? Army Force or Indian Army. Understand? Not to remember Indian Army. Understand? This is the second largest army in the world. Very very important in the class. Indian Army is the second largest army in the world. Which are the branches are included in Indian Army, or which are the branches comprises in Indian Army? Comprises means include. Understand? First one is infantry. Second one is cavalry, and third one is tank regiments. Tank regiments also known as armed troops. This means sometimes have the pronunciation G, Z like that. Understand? Regiments or infantry, cavalry, tank, regiments or armored troops. And next one is gunner, regiments or artillery. These are all branches or comprises into Indian Army. Duties of general. First one, which are the duties or performed by the general? General is the head officer of the Indian Army, is called what? General. Understand? First one is, see, responsible for discharging duties related to the control of the force. First one is, two, duties related to the control of the force. Control of the force. Understand? To discharging the duties related to the control of the force. This is the first duty or is performed by general. Understand? Second one, see training operations. Training operations. Operation is challenges. Operation is challenges and administration. Administration of the Indian Army. Very important. General performed important two duties. First one is to discharging the duties. Discharging means distribute the duties related to the control of the force. Understand? Second one is training. It means what? Two Indian Army soldiers for provide the trainings. Understand? Next, operations. Operations means challenges. Understand? And administration of Indian Army. These two is very important responsibilities of Indian Army head officer of general. Understand, children? See, today we will discuss first introduction about the our defense forces. Our defense forces is the first chapter of in civics part. Understand? Next, we will discuss responsibility of our defense forces and supreme power. Who had the supreme power of our defense forces? And next, we will discuss the divisions of our defense forces. Next, we will discuss the first division of our defense forces, that is Indian Army. Indian Army have or had its own branches, which are means infantry, cavalry, and also tank, regiments or troops, armored troops, and also gunner regiments or artillery. These are all the branches comprises into the Indian Army. How many soldiers are there in Indian Army? Means 11 lakh soldiers are there in our Indian Army, and 9,60,000 reserve soldiers are there in our Indian Army. And also the Indian Army head officer is called as general. Which are the duties or responsibilities are there for general? There are performing or responsibilities are two. First, you already know that one. And also very important, which are the important training centers of our defense forces? These are all matter we will discuss it today class in detail. Next class we will discuss what are the duties or performed by Indian Army. Andre Bharatiya Bhusena Padu Nirvahisuvanta Karyagalu Yavu Endu Mundina Taragathiyalli Navu Discuss Madona. Understand? Next class we will discuss which are the duties are performed